Now here we are to have a look at a condenser mic made by Jamelo. And this is a sort of microphone you'd use for going directly into your computer to record your speech or your acoustic instruments. Start with the bass plate, because obviously the first thing you have to do is put it all together. So here we go. We have our upright support, and we screw this on. It's so simple, this thing, that a four-year-old child could do it. I don't happen to have a four-year-old child, so that's why I'm doing it myself. Right, so there we are, stage one. Stage two, we take the mounting frame. This is the carriage that is going to actually support the microphone. And no, we don't go into the centre one. No, that's for the microphone. We go into the one at the side here. And again, we have to just twist round a few times. That's it. That's all that's required. So it's getting there, isn't it? It's getting there. Definitely getting there. Next, the microphone itself. And it's a fairly substantial piece of equipment. You can see there on the front of it, there's a volume control. Here on off light tells you it's actually made contact with the computer, and you have a little headphone socket so you can hear what you're actually doing as you're going on. Bottom end, there's your USB socket in there. We will attach that in a few moments. So sit it on my knee and there we go. Twirl it round. It's exciting, isn't it? It's exciting. There we are. Get in there, right. Okay, so far, so good. A couple more things to add to it before we plug it in. This will depend on whether you're recording indoors or outdoors. Now, if you're outdoors, because obviously this would plug into a laptop, and outdoors wind is a bit of a problem. Some of us have that problem indoors as well, but that's another story. So you have one of these little things, and this is your windshield, and you just have to pop it down over the top there, so it's nice and tight, and that will act as a filter against the sound of the wind. You could use it in the studio, and it will certainly be a very effective pop filter, because when you speak the P or B sounds, then there's an explosion basically coming from your lips, and well, you don't want that in your recording. It throws your levels off all the way. Now, because I'm going to recording indoors, I won't actually use that just now. I just thought I'd show you how to do it. It doesn't look like that when it comes out the box. It's flat, absolutely flat. So don't go looking for it and saying, where's my windshield? In the studio, we have this thing. It looks like a big lollipop. And there's a little bit of screw thread at the bottom. And you have to kind of look quite carefully to see where it is. But if we go in here, there, you can see it against at the top there. There is that's the hole you're looking for. So again, pop it on this up. And twirl away, twirl away, twirl away. Oh, there we are. And no, it doesn't sit up there. What you do is, well, you're at this side, so you bend it down until it's screening. That's it. So if I turn it to the side, it should look like that. If you don't like it, well, it just swings out of the road. If you find on a particular recording that you want it a little crisper, it will dull the recording ever so slightly, but probably better that than an explosion coming out. Right, so that's it. All I have to do now is plug it into the computer. Now that we've assembled our microphone, we have to make sure it all works with the computer and that they recognise one another. This computer is operating on Windows 10. I want to find my sound settings. There are two ways of doing it. I can go to the Start button at this side, or I can just simply click on the speaker icon in the bottom right hand corner. So I right click on that. A little list opens up, and I want the top one, Open Sound Settings. On this page at the top, we have our speaker output and we have our input. I want to make sure that my own speakers are still up here and the microphone hasn't suddenly popped in there. In the input section, this is what I'm looking for: microphone, brackets, and in capital letters, USB audio device, close brackets. Now on this machine, this being a PC, that's the only thing available. But if you've got a laptop, it's very probably got its own microphone, so you'll have to click on this little box and select the appropriate one. Now, closing that down, we'll try Windows Voice Recorder. We find that by clicking on the Start icon, and that pulls up all the different programs that we have. And we're going down to V, pretty near the end of things. And there we have Video Recorder. Click on that. And the recorder opens up. That's the play button right in the centre of the screen. The record button is down here at the bottom left. It's the blue circle with the microphone inside it. So we just click on that. And now we are recording. And as my voice goes up and down, you can see the circle getting darker as we go. Right, that should be enough. Now I'm going to play back, and what you're hearing is the recording that was made with the Jamalon mic playing through my speakers and being picked up by the camera's mic. A recording, and as my voice goes up and down, you can see that the circle getting darker as we go. Right, that should be enough. So there we go, that worked. Right, so close that down. Now, for my next trick, let's try something a bit more professional. This is a program called Adobe Audition. Got it free from the Open University when I did a couple of courses there many moons ago. Now here, what we're going to do is we're going to record, but before we do, let's think about this. If you have some sort of system like this, it might be Cubase or whatever, you're going to have to make sure that it recognises the microphone. So it's a very similar process to what we did with the Windows recorder. In this one it says options. It might say something like system. I'm looking for device order. And here I have playback devices, recording devices, MIDI output, and so on. Recording devices, I want to make sure that, yes, there it is. Microphone, USB audio device. Just the one I want. So that's okay. If it's not in your list, you have to maybe highlight it and click on it. Usual frustrating stuff that computers throw at you. Now, let's start a recording. And the next thing you hear will not be the camera microphone, but will actually be the Jamalon microphone itself. Now, the microphone is placed about 9 inches from my face, and I've got the pop screen in front of me. And what we're listening for in a microphone are, well, there's a few things. Is there any audible hiss or hum? To which the answer is no, there isn't. This is actually very clean. And how does it handle the difficult sounds? Well, those are the B's, the P's, and the S's. Big party sizzler. That's not a code word. No, it was just three examples. It seems to handle them absolutely fine. And as you can see from the sound wave that's appearing on the screen, we've got a good level. The volume dial on the microphone is set at 2 o'clock. Now, apart from speech, how does it handle a musical instrument? I have here an Ovation Celebrity classical guitar. Now let's give that a little strum. Again, nice healthy sound waves there. And how about vocals? Let me take your mind upon a long forgotten road, twisting through the undergrowth where no one ever goes, through a disused gateway and to his holy hill. Oh, remember him, he's waiting still. He's waiting still. He's waiting still. Now, before you ask, the first little bit of classical diddling was just me making it up on the spot. It wasn't any particular tune. That one was one of my songs called Remember Him. Yes, available on Amazon and iTunes, all those places. Now, what else about the microphone? Well, it costs at the moment, at the time of recording, it's about £40, so it's not going to break the budget. It's cheap as microphones go, but you don't really want a very, very expensive mic unless you're sitting in a soundproof studio. Because let's face it, you don't want to pick up the number 87 bus coming round the corner, or the cow giving birth 3 fields away. You want something that's reasonable, that's not going to pick up too much background noise, and this microphone fits the bill perfectly. The buy link can be found in the video description, and it's for Amazon UK, but for other countries, well, just Google it and I'm sure you'll find it.